Everyone, today we are going to start with the very interesting and useful software Adobe Photoshop. There are many versions available for the Photoshop in the market. The version that we will use is CS3. CS stands for Creative Suite. Okay, let's begin. What is Photoshop? You may have noticed that the photographs in the marriage albums or magazines or catalogs are so different from the common pictures. This alteration is made possible with the Photoshop software. Photoshop software is the most popular graphics editing program developed by the Adobe Systems. This is the most popular program and is widely used by graphic artists, web developers, photographers, as well as the persons like you and me who use it for pleasure. Most of the posters, magazine covers, book covers, brochures, etc. are created or edited with the help of Photoshop only. Now let's look at a little bit history of the Photoshop. Photoshop was developed in 1987 by two brothers, Thomas Knoll and John Knoll. Then, this sold its distribution licenses to the Adobe Systems Incorporated in 1988. Photoshop 1.0 was released on February 19, 1990 for Macintosh exclusively. That means it cannot be used, it was not available for Windows operating system, it was available only for the Macintosh. Then in 1993, Adobe Chief Architect Sitaraman Narayanan ported Photoshop to Microsoft Windows. Then it became so popular as Windows was the most popular or mostly used operating system in the world. What are the various features that makes the Photoshop so popular? There are many features available. Let's look at a few of them. The first feature is it provides a very user-friendly interface. That means you can easily use the various options of Photoshop to edit your images. It has the photo editing in lesser time. That means it requires lesser time and with little efforts you can easily edit your photographs. It provides very powerful tools to enhance the colors of an image, crop or resize an image without losing its quality. That means if you resize or crop an image, it will not lose its quality. It also provides tools for removing the unwanted objects. You can create the graphics for web applications with reduced file size. This is very important because when we create the web graphics, it should be lightweighted. It should not take much memory space. So it provides the feature for creating graphics with reduced file size. Then it also provides the feature for usage of layers. That means you can easily manipulate the different objects of the image without disturbing the other parts. Creating 3D icons. You can easily create 3D icons in Photoshop. Now let's take a look on the components of Photoshop window. This is the Photoshop window. You can open the Photoshop in the similar way as you open other programs on your computer, by clicking on start button and all programs option. When you open Photoshop, you will get this kind of window. In this window, there are various components. The first component that we are going to see is text menu, or you can also call it as menu bar. This text menu has the different kind of menus like file, edit, image, layer, type, select, etc. These are similar to the tabs that we use in MS Word or MS PowerPoint. Like when we click on one tab, it will give you the options related to that tab. Similar way, when we click on any menu, we will get the pull down menu. These will display the options related to that menu. Below the text menu, you will find the context menu. This context menu, the options of this context menu will change according to the tool that we select from the tools palette or the option that we had selected from this menu bar. Now, on the right hand side, you will find, on the left hand side, you will see there is a tools palette. This tools palette has the various tools that you can use to draw the objects on the stage or on the working area, or you can use these tools to make some changes or editing in your photographs. These are the various tools that you can select from this tools palette and use them on this workspace. This is the workspace in the center of the window. This is the workspace where we work with the pictures or photographs. Let's look at the tools palette once again. Here, these are the various tools in the tools palette. You can place mouse pointer on any tool. It will indicate the name of the tool as well as the shortcut key from the keyboard. You move your mouse pointer, place it on any tool. It will give you the name of that tool as well as the shortcut key that you can use from the keyboard to activate that tool. Second thing, as you can see, there is a small triangle, black color triangle at the bottom of the tool. This triangle indicates that this tool has some inner tools, some hidden tools are there, which you can open by clicking on this arrow. As I click on this, I can see there is a tool, brush tool, pencil tool, color replacement tool, and mixer brush tool. Similarly, if I click on this shapes tool, I can find gradient tool and paint bucket tool. Similarly, if I click on this, I will find some hidden tools there also, blur tool or sharpen tool and smudge tool. Now, the tools of this tools palette are divided into four categories. As you can see, there is a line that indicates this is a separate section. Now, the first section that you can see here is, this is your selection and crop tools. These tools are used to select the various parts of the images in different ways. Second category that you can see is this is the retouching and paint tools. These tools can be used to retouch your images or make some changes in the images, like red eye spot, spot healing brush tool, healing brush tool, or some gradient tools are there, or eraser tool, blur, burn. All these tools can be used to retouch your photographs. The third category is at the bottom, at the this is the third category. This can be used for drawing or type tools are there. These are the drawing and type tools. These tools can be used to draw something on the workspace or typing text. And after that, at the bottom of the all, this tools palette, you will find this area. In this area, you will find the annotation or measurement tools, like zoom tool is there, hand tool is there, or color, background color and foreground color tools are there. Okay, now this tools palette, this is the tools palette. Tools palette is divided into four categories. Tools of this tools palette are divided into four categories. The number one, selection and crop tools. Then these are the retouching and paint tools. And after that, there is a drawing and type tools, and last one is annotation and measurement tools. Okay. On the right hand side of the window, there is separate area that is called palettes, that is used for palettes. These are the various palettes available. That these are also called the floating dialog boxes. These floating dialog boxes or palettes has the various options that you can use to edit the images. Like we are having their various palettes, like this is the color palette, this is the adjustment palette, and this is the layers palette. All these palettes can be used to work with the images. These are the floating palettes because we can move them anywhere in the area that we want. Okay, and secondly, there is an expand top button also. This can be used to hide the palettes temporarily that we do not want to use for some time. I can click here. The palettes are still available, but options of this palette, these palettes are hidden. I can click it again, and to these options will be expand. Okay, now this is the Photoshop, all about the Photoshop window, all the components of the Photoshop window. I hope you understand the today's topic. Now read page number 57 and 58 in your books. In the next tutorial, we will learn how to place or open an image in Photoshop. Thank you.